how do you describe a productive Muslim? What is the like a perfect image of a productive Muslim? What all like we should be doing in with respect to that?
Well, see, the perfect example of a productive Muslim is the Prophet Muhammad alayhi salam. Be it in his actions or in his acknowledgement of approvals of what other people did in his presence, or his statements. And one of the most famous, profound, prophetic traditions that is authentically attributed to the Prophet alayhi salam, both in the Muslim of Imam Ahmad, and it was authenticated by Sheikh Al-Albani, and it's in Adab Al-Mufrad of Imam Bukhari and in multiple places, is the famous hadith that is considered the foundation of productivity. And it is the statement of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam who said, إِنْ قَامَتِ السَّاعَةُ وَفِي يَدِي أَحَدِكُمْ فَسِيلَةٌ فَإِنْ اسْتَطَاعَ أَلَّا تَقُومَ السَّاعَةُ حَتَّى يَغْرِسَهَا فَلْيَغْرِسَهَا. If the hour is about to be established, and you imagine now you have to go back to Surah Al-Hajj. And when you read Surah Al-Hajj, you have a description about the Qiyamah. وَتَرَى النَّاسَ سُكَارَى وَمَا هُمْ بِسُكَارَى يَوْمَ تَذَلُ كُلُّ مُرْضَعَةٍ عَمَّا أَرْضَعَتْ. The day every nursing woman will let go of her child. And then you see the people appearing to be drunk, but they're not drunk. The Yawm Al-Qiyamah is a massive, scary, terrifying day. And the Prophet ﷺ is telling us, if the hour is going to be established, and if one of you has in his hand fasila is actually a small palm tree. So you can grow palms through the actual date, the ajwa, the seeds, or you can just plant a small one to grow. If one of you is able to plant that tree, then let him do so. Even if it is the qiyamah has taken place, resurrection, and the end of time is coming, and you have the ability to do something productive, even though you're not going to see the fruits of it, because you know that what's going to come after is done. It is a foundation to teach the Muslims about that state of mind, that consciousness of being productive and utilizing all of the things Allah gave us for our benefit and the benefit of others. Because what will happen from this is, first of all, you will get the ajr. And second of all, even if you don't get to see it, assuming that people live, assuming you die, the scholars take from this that even if you're going to die, then you have to also think about being productive for the generations that come after you. You have to think about the generations that come after you. Umar ibn Khuzaymah bin Thabit said, I heard Umar ibn Khattab say to my father, what is preventing you from growing vegetation in this farm of yours? He had a little land that he wasn't utilizing for farming. He said, I'm an old man. I could die tomorrow. And so Umar said, I insist upon you that you will grow vegetation. And then the Rawi of the Hadith said, and wallahi, I saw Umar al-Khattab aiding my father in planting and doing the agriculture for that particular land, helping him in growing it. Again, teaching you that the mentality of the person, I'm an old man, I'm going to die. Yes, but there will be people who will come after you, be it your children, be it the ummah at large, be it the non-Muslims, whatever. You should be thinking about what legacy, if I may say, you will leave behind for the generations to come. And so the productivity is not only related to you, rather productivity is about you and what happens after you. So who is a better example than that, than the Prophet alayhi salam and the Sahaba? What did the Sahaba, what were they able to accomplish in that duration of time that we are speaking about them 1400 years later? Can you imagine how productive they must have been? How productive was Abu Hurairah that until now people say, عن أبي هريرة عن الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم أنه قال, so on and so forth. How productive was he? How productive was Imam Bukhari and Imam Muslim? And there's a difference of opinion about Suyuti and others. We will discuss those later. The Ummah is the Ummah of productivity. In every area of life, not just in matters of the religion, which are the most important and the priority, no doubt, but even in other fields of science, in fields of anything that actually benefits, in a generic sense, anything that benefits mankind, is something that a Muslim is supposed expected to be in the pioneer and the forerunner and the foremost in holding that flag of productivity and exemplifying that, because the one who set that standard for us is the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, both in his action and his statements. The Prophet ﷺ married how many women? How productive do you have to be in that area for you to have so many women? And you look after them and you maintain them. And then you have, he's responsible for whole ummah. He's responsible for the sahaba. He's responsible for those who will come after them. Subhanallah. Subhanallah. So what better example do we have than the Prophet ﷺ? Allah says, لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ. You have in the message of Allah the best example. لِمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُ اللَّهَ وَالْيَوْمَ الْآخِرِ. For the one who hopes for Allah on the last day, وَذَكَرَ اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا, and he remembers Allah Azza wa Jal often.